Hey guys, I'm just going to make a crock pot soup, so I wanted to share it with you. And this is one of those soups where you just, you know, you use what you have. You don't have to go out and shop for, you know, all these crazy things. Me personally, I always have carrot, celery, and onion in my house, always, all year round. It's just a staple for me. So if you don't have it, you know, it's definitely a good thing to use and have on hand for soups and different things like that. So I just have a rotisserie chicken from Walmart that's fully cooked. I'm going to disassemble it and cut out all the white meat to use in the soup. I have just some Trader Joe's petite sweet peas, and I'm just going to use you know, about a half cup, like a handful of those. I have some lentils, which I will just rinse and put right in the crock pot. And then I have about a third of a head of green cabbage left over from my corned beef that I made last week. So I figured I would throw that in. Again, carrot, celery, and onion, which is my staple for soup. My chicken broth, and then I'm going to also use some white cannellini beans. I just have my crock pot lined, and it's on high, sort of preheating. And I'm just going to get everything prepped and ready to go in. Okay guys, so I have everything prepped. I took all the white meat off the rotisserie. This is about 2 cups, maybe a little bit shy of the breast meat. I have rinsed and drained my lentils. I have my beans rinsed and drained, and I have all my veggies cut up and prepped and my broth. So I'm going to open up the crock pot here. It's preheated on high, and me personally, I like to start with the veggies. So all the veggies right into the crock pot. And then I just kind of want to even them out, and then I'm going to add the lentils right on top like that, and then I'm going to add the meat, and I add the broth last, as you can probably tell. So we're going to do the meat right on top. Again, this is preheated on high, but it is going to cook on low. I just like to preheat it on high to get it nice and hot to receive everything. So I have all the meat in, and I'm going to add my chicken broth right in. And honestly guys, crock pot cooking is great if you are a new cook, if you are a busy cook, if you're a career person, if you're a family person. I really can't think of anyone who, you know, doesn't enjoy using a crock pot once in a while. I use mine a lot in the fall and winter, a lot more than in the summer, because in the summer we grill a lot. Okay, so I have my chicken in, and I'm just going to wash my hands quickly, and I will show you how I bring this all together. Okay guys, I'm back, and what I did was just give my hands a quick wash, and then I just, like my usual, I stirred everything, you know, so that the bottom came to the top, and everything sort of, you know, combines rather than just sits in one spot. And it's so funny how it's literally raw, and it looks good already. So I love the cabbage. The cabbage is going to wilt down a lot. It's going to definitely shrink. Now I'm just going to add some black pepper, just kind of several hearty shakes. I'm not going to add salt because the chicken broth does have salt, and you can always add that later. I have some dried parsley, which I'm going to add a few big shakes. And then I also have some dried Italian seasoning, which I'm going to add, again, a few big shakes, so I can get the top to open. There we go. And sort of mix a little pile on top. And lastly, we are just going to stir once again to combine all the seasonings into the broth. And it's pretty much foolproof from here, guys, because after this is all stirred and combined, I'm just going to put the lid on, turn it down to low, and just let it do its thing for about 6 hours, and it's going to be delicious. It's going to be thick. It's really not going to be very brothy. It's going to be almost more of a borderline like a stew. In that case, I'm not going to add any pasta or rice, which I would if I didn't maybe have the cabbage or the lentils in here. It would need more substance. But because of the cabbage and the lentils, it's really going to make it very hearty. And obviously, I will show you guys what it looks like when it's finished. But as you can see, it was easy. It's healthy. I just used things that I already had on hand. I had the cabbage left over from a recipe last week. So that worked out great, and I had lentils, which I always have red and the green lentils in my pantry. So here we go. We're just going to set it and sort of forget it, and we'll be back later on today to show you what it looks like. Okay, guys, so our soup is done. We're going to take the lid off and see how thick it's gotten. I definitely wouldn't call it a stew, but it's definitely less brothy. Everything looks like it held up really well. It smells so good. And you know what, guys? This is actually a really healthy soup. Cabbage has like no calories, and it's really good for you. White meat chicken, you know, all the veggies, the beans, the lentils. Really, I can't think of anything bad to say. So we are about to dig in. I'm just going to kind of scoop it into bowls and top it with some Parmesan cheese, and we are ready for dinner.